share Carolyn's views about the proposed mine. But before I do that, a couple things that I know Congresswoman will want me to say. First of all, to commend everyone who's come out to this and the other hearings. Yeah. She's always believed that an engaged citizenry is the best part of a democracy and makes a democracy work. And we commend everyone for coming out today and other times to express their views pro and con on the mine, proposed mine. And also a commendation to Jim Upchurch and his staff for their openness to our office's advice and input regarding venues, times of these hearings, to make sure that the hearings were accessible to as many members of our community as possible. And also, as we've seen in the early presentation by Mr. Upchurch, commendations for looking at the issues that have been raised so far and conducting additional research and analysis. The words that follow are the words that the Congresswoman has expressed about the Rosemont mine.
I don't believe you.
So
she's not speaking, though. I don't believe you.
That if the Congresswoman were here, she would say that if we want to make a wise decision for the present and the future of our community, we must consider the pros and cons of the decision to go forward with this mine. And her statement is as follows. Anyone who has driven down State Highway 83 knows that it traverses some of the most majestic and sweeping vistas in the southeastern part of our state. Winding its way from Vail to Parker Canyon Lake, the road meanders through a breathtaking landscape that has earned a place of distinction in Stuart M. Green's Scenic Driving from Arizona. He said, it's an immense land of fairway views, faraway views, with a pastoral beauty unlike any other Arizona drive. The uniqueness of this area is why I firmly and unequivocally oppose the mine plan by Augusta Resources Corporation to permanently despoil it with an open pit copper mine. I am not opposed to all mining, but like many of my constituents, I have been opposed to the Rosemont proposal since its inception. Windswept mine tailings and runoff would pollute our air and groundwater. Noise pollution would result from the round-the-clock operations, and traffic hazards would increase because of the fleet of heavy trucks rumbling up and down area roads. All of this would destroy a popular recreation area that contributes significantly to our tourist economy. One of the Congresswoman's most significant concerns is water. She says, then there is the problem of the mine's water use. The enormous new demands for precious groundwater at a time when the local water table is dropping could be catastrophic. The mine owners expect to pump 100,000 acre feet of water over 20 years, enough water to supply the needs of 300,000 homes per year, or enough to submerge all 26 square miles of Green Valley 6 feet deep. And there's a question of water quality, which apparently is now going to be further addressed by the Forest Service's research and analysis. The environmental and social effects of the community to our community through Rosemont Mine will be immense and irrevocable, and we really need to reconsider going forward with this mine. Concerns about the mine run across the political spectrum. Resolutions in opposition to the mine have been approved by local jurisdictions, including Pima County, Santa Cruz County, the City of Tucson.
Congressman says,
3,050 mistake. No worries of the Congressman. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ron.
So, again, I ask folks to please cooperate. It's going to be a very long afternoon with very few speakers as we continue to do and comment for
me up there.
So, I would really appreciate it if you would cooperate and allow folks their opportunity to say their piece. That's what everybody came here today for, was to be able to provide your opinion.
First speaker was not of a propaganda,
it's a big break.
Mark Williams, Floyd Edwards. The Multiple Use Mining Act of 1955 is an act to, quote, amend the general mining laws to permit more efficient management and administration of the surface resources of the public lands by providing for multiple use of the same tracts